Monton, New Brunswick, weighing 225, Emil Dupree. His opponent from Lafayette, Indiana, weighing 248, Bruiser Afflis. The referee...
Dick the Bruiser, Bob.
Just the Bruiser?
Just the Bruiser.
Just the Bruiser. The referee is Pete Sacco.
This almost seems like a mismatch because Bruiser Afflis is a rough, tough customer. Even Dupree is a young fella. Afflis, you may remember, he comes from Lafayette, Indiana. He's as mean as they come. He just doesn't seem to want anybody to have any fun in there. He played high school football and was named every all-state team in the state of Indiana. Then he moved down to the Big Ten, and he was one of the roughest linemen that Purdue University ever had. Then he became one of the toughest professional players ever to play ball with the Green Bay Packers. And maybe young Mr. Dupree here has got something for the Bruiser, eh? But he is rough and tough and nasty. Has very little scientific skill. Afflis was the offensive captain of the Packers back in 1954, which is his last year in pro football. And at one time, he broke the leg of a Chicago Bear linesman who had boasted that he was the toughest lineman in football, and Afflis broke his leg. He's a rough, tough character. He has won the U.S. Heavyweight Championship. He won that from Wilbur Snyder back in 1957, lost it to Hans Schmidt. You hear that voice? Now, young Emil Dupree, who's dishing it out right now, is just 23 years old. He comes from Moncton, New Brunswick in Canada. But he's been wrestling as a pro for about 6 years. He started when he was very young. And he's engaged in a knockdown, drag-out battle with Bruiser Afflis tonight. But Afflis talks all the time in there. He's muttering and grumbling and calling Dupree a bum. I can hear him. He'll say, "Take this, you bum." He's got a voice like an army tank going over a ton of gravel. I tell you, Dupree is no patsy in there. He's dishing out as much as he's taking. A whip. Afflis doesn't even want to be known by his last name. He told Manny White, just call him Bruiser. Here comes Dupree, and he didn't quite get out of the ring. Now he's out with an assist from Afflis. Afflis is coming right after him. He banged his head into the judges' stand. Here we have a judges' stand down here where the judges sit. Afflis has got a body slam him right here on the rope. No, sir, he broke his back over the top. He got him on the apron and hit his back right across the corner. Now Afflis doing all this outside the ring. He caught Dupree right across the edge of the ring, the apron. He's wild at Afflis. He'd be a good man to see in there with Fritz von Erich. Let them tear each other apart. Now he's doing knee drops. He's trying. He's got his own Prussian drop. He's coming off the top rope with the knee to the throat. This guy is just vicious. There's the three count. Well, Afflis has not had enough. He's going to do more. Now he's after Pete Sacco. Boy, he just doesn't care for anybody. He wants to get that job done as quickly as possible. He doesn't care how he does it.
The time, 4 minutes.
Now he's going to work again on
the winner, the Bruiser.
The Bruiser is the winner, but he's working again on Emil Dupree. Look at him. He's like a lion. He's got all Marty Moscato's men. I think it's time for me to move a little bit. They're taking him out forcefully. Look at him. He doesn't want to go out. They finally forced him out.
Watching, I'ma make you fall in love. Just step back and watch me.